तदा पुरुषो आत्मानं केवलं प्रकृते परं निरंतरं स्वयं ज्योति अनिमानं अखंडितम्. दिस इज सेल्फ रियलाइजेशन. सेल्फ रियलाइजेशन मीन्स टू सी वन्स प्रॉपर आइडेंटिटी. At the present moment, we are not finding out our proper identity. We are saying to the body, I see you, your body, and you see me, my body. We have no vision of the real person who is occupying this body. That is the first lesson we get from Bhagavad Gita. Dehi nasmin yatha dehi. Dehi, this body, is called deha. And the owner of the body is called dehi. Dehi nasmin yatha dehi kumarajo namjara tatha dehantara prapti. So, when we can see that we are not this body, I am not this body, that is beginning of self-realization. That is called Brahma-bhuta stage. Aham Brahmasmi. I am not this material body. Aham Brahmasmi. This is self-realization. So, what is the identification of the jiva, of the soul? Very minute. Animanam, very, very minute, infinitesimal. God is infinite and we are infinitesimal, very small particle. That's like sun. Sun is very big, but the sun shine, it is a combination of very minute, bright articles, atoms, everyone knows. It is a combination of, dazzling, bright. Similarly, we are also a small, bright particle. the same quality, Swayam Jyoti. Just like God or Brahma is Jyoti, we are also Jyoti. But Brahma is all-pervading, infinite, we are Unimanam. The Mayavadi theory is that at the present moment I am the same. Theory is Ghatakas Patakas. Just like in a ghat or in a pot, there is, within the pot, there is sky, and outside the pot, there is sky. So, the separation is due to the wall of the pot. When the wall is broken, then the inside sky and the outside sky become one. This is Mayavada theory. Therefore, here it is said, akhanditam. Akhanditam means not that the sky within the pot is fragmented from the whole sky. That cannot be. In the Bhagavad Gita also it is said, acchiddayam, acchidda. It cannot be cut into pieces. Akhandi. That means it is minute perpetually, eternally. Mamaivangsa jiva bhuto jiva loke sanatana. Sanatana means eternally. We are small. Anu, animanam, and God or Krishna is vibhu. God is great. Means nobody is equal to him. Nobody is greater than him. That is greatness. God is great But we say God is great, but we do not know how great He is. He is so great that millions of universes are coming from the holes of His body. Jasyaika nishyasita kalam athavalambha jivanti loma vilaja jagadanna natha. Vishnu mahanisa yajasya kalavishesha govinda madipurisam tamaham bhajami. Millions of universes are coming from the breathing of Mahavishnu. So that is a little idea of the greatness of God, Krishna. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, athava bahunaitena kingyatena tavarjana vishtabhyam aham krishnam ekanshena sthito jagat. This jagat, this material world, is situated on the strength of one part of me. So this is self-realization. We must understand our position. In the Puranas also, our minute particle identification, what is that? 1/10,000 part of the top of the ear. We cannot see even the top of the ear. That you divide. Kesha agra, the front portion of the ear. Kesagra satabhavas. You divide into 100 parts. Satadha kulpitasya cha. Again take one part and divide into 100 parts. That is the dimension of the jiva. That small particle is there within the ant, the microbic germ, and that part is within the elephant. Jiva-bhuta-mahava, that is the dimension. So self-realization means one must know his identity. That identity, that small particle is there, within me, within you. Dehi nasmi jathat dehi. Dehi is within, the deha. But because it is so small with our material eyes, it is not possible to see. There is no such instrument that you can find out. Therefore, on account of our inability to find it out, we say it is nirakar. Because we cannot calculate what is the akar, what is the dimension. But the akar is there. The living entity has got full akar. If you have studied the small microbes, sometimes I see at night when I work, a small insect, just like a full stop. It is walking, that means the whole physiological combination and anatomy physiology is there. But you cannot see just like a full stop. So within that there is the soul. And within the elephant or big animal, there is also the soul. The soul is there. Asmin dehi, dehi nasmin jatha dehi, that is there. So when we actually realize what we are, brahmanubhuti, then our life is successful. Now we are identifying with this body. So long we are identifying with this body, we are no better than the cats and dogs. Whatever knowledge you may have, scientific knowledge, if you do not know yourself, then you are nothing but the animal. The animal does not know. Jashyatma buddhi kunapi tridhatuke. If somebody considers that this body and self identify, I am Indian, I am American, I am Brahman, I am Khatri, I am man, I am woman, I am elephant, and so on. So, this kind of identification, dasyatma buddhi Kunape Tridhatuke. Kunape means this is bag made of kapha pitta vayu. Tridhatu. Jashatu buddhi kunape tridhatuke sadhik kalatra disubhoma yujjadi. And thinking that in bodily relationship, I am thinking he is my own man or relative. Jashatu buddhi kunape tridhatuke sadhik kalatradisu. Kalatra means because we have intimate relation with woman and offspring, children born of her, the kalatradisu. And bhoma yujjadi, and the land as ijja. Ijja means worshipable. Nowadays it is very prominent. I heard that for land there was a fight in somewhere near. So that is going on, nation to nation, community to community. The bhoma yujjadi, they are thinking, this land is mine, the land of my birth is mine. We have seen there was fight between Hindu and Muslim during partition days. This is my Pakistan, this is my Hindustan. So bhoma yujjadi, jashat buddhi kunapeti dhatuki sadhik kalatradisu bhoma yujjadi. Jatitha buddhi salile. Now we go to Tirthasthan. We go to Haridwar and Vrindavan and other nice holy places, and the Christians go to Jordan. So Jerusalem, they take bath in the Jordan. So Jatitha buddhi salile. Salile means water. Jashat buddhi kunapeti dhatuke jatitha buddhi salile na kareti janesu abhigyesu, but have no interest to understand his identification, spiritual identification, from the acharya, janesu abhigyesu. Abhigya means one who knows. Acharya. Tadvijnanartham sa gurumeva abhigacchet. This is the basic instruction. To understand your spiritual identity, you must find out a proper guru. Tadvijnanartham sa gurumeva abhigacchet. So he has no such knowledge. Acharyaman purusha veda. So he has no knowledge. The superficial. Saeva gokhara. Such person is no better than the cows and the asses. Means animals. So this is self-realization. When one understands that I am not this body. I am minute particle of the Supreme. Krishna says, everything is said there, we have to realize it. Krishna says, Mamivam. Although Aṃsa, Aṃsa and Aṃsi, the whole and the part, part is never equal to the whole. That is axiomatic truth. But it is equal in quality. Just like little particle of gold is also gold. It is nothing but else. Similarly, although you are part and parcel of Krishna, very minute, infinitesimal, animanam, perpetually, eternally, still we are not as big as Krishna. Just like small particle of this sea water, the chemical composition is the same. You will find the same test. And if you analyze, you will find all the same ingredients, chemicals, within the small particle. But the small particle is never equal to the sea, small particle of the water. This is it. If I think, because I am qualitatively one with God, therefore I have become God. That is mistake. That is abhisuddha buddhaya. They have been described in the Shastras as abhisuddha, unclean intelligence. Unclean intelligence. Jennero bindakha vimukta manina. Some Mayavadi philosophers think that I am the same. Soham. Soham does not mean that I am equal to God. Nobody can be equal to God or greater than God. That is not God. Krishna says in the Bhagavad, matta parataram nanyat kimchit asti dhananyat. So nobody can be greater than God or equal to God. That means greatness of God. Asama urdha. Asama means nobody is equal to him. And nobody is greater than him. That is God. If somebody claims to be God, then he has to prove that nobody is equal to him and nobody is greater than him. Then he is God. This is the simple definition of God. That nobody equal to him and nobody greater than him. That is Krishna. Krishna says that matta parataram nanyat kinchis asti dhananjaya. My dear Dhananjaya Arjuna, there is no more superior authority than me. In the Brahma Sangita, it is said, Ishara Parama Krishna. Ishara means controller. So we small living entities, very minute, still we are controller. We control. At least we control our family members, my wife, my children. Or if I am bigger, I control my office. Or I control my factory. I control the country. I become president. In this way, controller, bigger controller, I go to the Brahma, the controller of the universe. But he is also not supreme controller. It is said, Tene Brahma is meditating. Although he is the greatest creature, living creature within this universe, he is also meditating to learn controlling. Tene Brahma Rida Adhikabhaye Mayanti Jasuraya. He learned first of all how to control over the universe. Then he became Brahma. Of course he was born Brahma, but still he has to be educated. Actually, we require to be educated. So Brahma was educated. So who educated him? Krishna. Aham adirhi devanam. Krishna says, Aham adirhi devana. Deva, the original Deva is Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesha. So Vishnu, Krishna is Vishnu, but he is the instructor of Brahma and Shiva. This is the Shastric conclusion. That is greatness. So, we should not falsely claim that I am as great as the Supreme God. No. We should understand this. Animanam Swayam Atto Jyoti. I am as effulgent. Just like spark. Spark is jyoti, but not as brilliant, effulgent as the original fire. The original fire, but there are some sparks. You have got experience. The spark is also jyoti. If a spark falls on your cloth, it will immediately burn. The burning capacity is there, but it is not as good as the original fire. Sayanga jyoti, here it is said, nirantaram. So, nirantaram means, there is, so far jyoti is concerned, there is no difference. But, the small, very small, animanam, akhanditam, this is self-realization. Don't falsely claim that because I am qualitatively one with God, therefore I am God. No. You may be God. God means controller. But you are not the Supreme God. The Supreme God is Krishna. Ishara Parama. Parama means Supreme. We are Ishara. Maybe Ishara. I may be Ishara for few person. Another may be for a big nation. Another may be for the... You can go on, increase it. But you cannot reach the position of God. That is Abhusiddha Buddha. Therefore, Shastra says, Jennaira Bindakha Bhimukta Manina Tai Astabhavad Avishuddha Buddha. One was advanced very much in spiritual knowledge. But he's thinking himself, now I have become liberated. Sometimes they claim, I have become Narayan. Therefore, Mayavadis, they address one another, Namo Narayan. Everyone has become Narayan. So how everyone can become Narayan? Is so many Narayan? No. Narayan is what? God is what? Narayan. Therefore, Shastra warns, Jastu Narayanam Devam Brahma Rudradi Devata Samattena Vikheta Sa Pasandi Bhagadruvam. This Pasandi. If one compares Narayan with other demigods, now unfortunately it has come to so downtrodden position, the intelligence, that they are talking of Daridra Narayan. What is this? This is first. Narayan is the exalted Supreme Personality of Godhead. Even Shankaracharya, he says, Narayana para abhaktyat. Narayan is beyond this universe. Para abhaktyat. Abhaktyat annasam. And the whole universe is product of this abhaktya. So we should not compare Narayan with anyone else. But to speak of Daridra, that is a foolishness. Narayan is Lakshmipati, the husband, the controller of the goddess of fortune. And how he can be Daridra? This is misunderstanding. That was Shastra warns, Jastu Narayanam Devam Brahma Rudradi Devati Samatena Vikheta Sapasandi Bhavidruvam. If anyone thinks that Narayan or other demigods are equal to Narayan, so Pashandi, he is Pashandi, atheist. So we should not think like that. You may think that you have become liberated, you have got the position of Narayan. That is all false thinking. Abhisuddha Buddha, they have been addressed as Abhisuddha, non-purified Buddha, intelligent, not intelligent. Just Jannero Bindakha Vimukta Manina Tai Astubhavad. This is why these things happen. One compares Narayana with ordinary demigod or ordinary man. Because Abhisuddha Buddhaya, their intelligence is not purified. So, Arujya Kichena Parang Padang Tata, such person, by severe austerities and penances, may elevate oneself to the position of Brahma. Still, Arujya Kichena Parang, Parang Padang means Brahma Padang. Arjya kichena paranga patanga tata patanti adha. Again he falls down. Why? Anadita jusmatang raya. Because they neglected to worship your lotus feet. So, unless one becomes devotee, there is no secure position in the spiritual world. One may, just like a very crude example, you may have very powerful Sputnik, just like these people are trying to go to the moon planet with powerful, what is it called, the machine? Rocket, yes. But then, going with great force, but Arujya Kuchena, similarly one can rise up to the Brahma effulgence. But if there is no shelter, just like these people are going, but they don't get any shelter. But they come down again. Similarly, one by severe austerities and penances may go up to the Brahma Loka, but he has no position. He has no position. Because in the Brahma Loka or Vaikuntha Loka, in the Parabhoma, the spiritual sky, there are spiritual planets. They are called Vaikuntha Loka. Hundreds and millions. There are very, very big, big planets than these material planets. So unless you get a shelter in one of the planets, then you again fall down. So that is because we are after Ananda, Satchit Ananda, simply to rise to the platform of Brahma, that is Sat, partial realization of the Absolute Truth, Sat. Then Chit, Chit means knowledge, that is also partial. Ananda, Sat, Chit, Ananda. When that Ananda you cannot get, just like if you simply in the sky fly, you don't get Ananda. Therefore you have come to down, come down again to the airplane, airport. Without that, there is no Ananda. Similarly, simply rising up to the Brahma effulgence, there is no Ananda. Ananda means you have to enter into the spiritual planet where Narayan Krishna is there. Parastasmattu bhavanya bhakta bhaktya sanatana. You have entered to that eternal planet. You must get some residence. The impersonalists, they do not get that. They remain, just like you remain in the sky, you cannot be happy. You want some planet. But if you cannot get planet, then again you come back in this planet. So arujya kritchena paranga patanga tata patanti adha. Again in this material world. Therefore, we have to take to Krishna consciousness. That is real self-realization. And what is that? Very simple thing. Krishna says, janma karma me dibbam je janati tat. If you simply try to understand what is Krishna, why does he come, what is his business, what is his form, janma karma me dibbam je janati tat tat, takta deham punar janma nahiti mameti. Simple process. You try to understand Krishna. This is Krishna consciousness moment. We are simply teaching how to understand Krishna. And if anyone is fortunate to understand, then his life is successful. Janma karma medit bhavanja. So, tada purusa atmanam kevalam prakite param. Prakite param. Now we are thinking, I am the product of this material world. I am Indian. What I am Indian? Because my body is Indian, I am Indian? No. I am the spirit, so aham brahmasmi. That is self-realization. The whole world is fighting. I am Indian, I am American, I am Pakistani, I am Hindustani, I am Hindu, I am Muslim, I am Brahmin. Dehatma buddhi. So one has to realize that I am not this body. Kevalam pakite param. I am beyond this world. I have a far transcendental to this material world. How it is possible? Tadala kamalo bhadas. We have discussed this verse yesterday. Hanga mama bhimana uthya uthai kamalo bhadi. Kamalo bhadi. Malai. So long we have got the desire, lusty desire and greediness for enjoying this material world, then it is not possible. We have to free, we have to become free from these lusty desires. So this is Bhakti Yoga process. Bhakti Yoga, if we adopt the Bhakti Yoga process, then you become free from the Kamalobha. Kamalobha means the influence of Kamagun and Rajagun. As soon as we become free from, we have to become free from all the gunas. Cheta gunai, cheta khalu asya bandhaya. To become free from the gunas, that is simply explained in the Bhagavad Gita. You engage yourself in devotional service, you become immediately free from the influence of the gunas. Manchabhyabhicharini bhakti yogena jasevat. Anyone who is engaged in rendering service to the Lord, bhakti yoga, bhakti yoga according to the, because we are not expert in approaching the Supreme Lord, therefore we have to follow the principles of bhakti yoga as enunciated by the acharya, sadhu shastra, by the order of spiritual master, by the order of the shastras, you have to execute this function of bhakti yoga. And as soon as you become attached to it, you become practiced to it,